for the grand final spot against Echo in FBL.
Echo versus Brand.
Here we go.
I would say that. Yeah, it probably is the Guinevere.
I would bet money if people in the crowd watching Worlds. That'd be someone just having Worlds on their phone.
Demon Gate is a little bit faster than Akai, even without the help of his teammates. That should be the case. And look at that. Ruby as well as the Arlet. They fast cleared the XP lane and then they go to the mid lane. Because they want to contest the Lethal Wanderer, I would assume.
Yeah, but they're not sharing the XP, so Ogwen gets level 2. That is pretty interesting. So they want to manage it until the level 4. Not as much as just securing the level.
How loud is the stream, by the way? Do you make it louder? We think a better draft? RSGPH has a better draft effect than Snowball early. Honestly, no. I think RSGPH has a better draft overall. And Bren, like, depends on Marco being fed. If Marco wins and gets fed, Bren can, like, stomp. But RSG, I think overall, is a better team comp.
You actually securing a demon shoe instead of a defensive shoe.
Yeah. Fred not meta anymore? No, Fred's banned.
Much more on the lane because he has to spam those first kills to be able to clear it.
Yep.
A Super Marco 2v1, I don't think it really matters.
Yep.
It's a 1-1.
Especially because of the needles and towers.
Yeah.
It forced that one out. You see how quickly a Paquito can clear out the lanes. We're gonna be going for the switch.
Bren or RSG? I think Bren would win if they're full tryharding, but I don't know if they're like hard trying at all. I don't know what the hook was. You getting some chip damage on Nats. Pretty good, pretty good. Now for the turtle flip. Demon Kite, no dash, just used it. Aqua with the ult. Kyle hope the ult as well. Who gets it? Kyle gets Retry off. Light gets pulled. Light has flicker out. Demon Kite not in a good spot here. Demon Kite here is just gonna fall. Good turtle take from Bren and a free camp along with a kill. Overall, really solid start for Bren.
Getting the advantage of a very nice rotation. They know that they can go for the switch mid lane as well as the XP lane, switch their lanes before the turtle fight, and knowing that Few can actually take his time because he's a Nangela. He's playing Nangela, so he could just use his ultimate.
Fuck, I want to watch the world show.
Into the fight. Doesn't matter where there is.
Anywho, 500 gold lead for Bren so far. Pretty solid.
Does have the ultimate anyway, so very nice.
Mass of the gold camp taken.
So just want to... Just a reminder to you guys that these two teams conquered Southeast Asia in their own ways. AP Bren was a SEA Games champion. RSG, though, MSC champion in 2022, beating RRQ to grand final. So, a lot of experience, a lot of skills as well, and Demon Kite back in the lineup for RSG.
Okay, 3 minutes in after that first turtle fight, both of the teams, they kind of want to tone their tempo down. Again, waiting for sure information. Perhaps a gold lane can be their focus now.
That was a very interesting objective take battle because it's two heavy spins from Aqua and both Kyle TZ. But I think Demon Kite somehow with a Gwen.
Maybe Bren seems to have the map dominance here, map pressure. Ogwen with the hook on a Demon Kite. Demon Kite not in a good spot. Repentance Rage goes off. Kyle trying to pin Demon Kite but dies to Emon. Big damage. Phew. Ults Ogwen instead of Kyle. Misplay from Bren. It was a good pin, but like not a lot of follow-up. Holy shit, and Phew gets hooked by Light. Fly with the final slash on Emon, but Emon flickers out. Demon Kite engaging on Ogwen. Ogwen lives though. RSG turned that around really well. It was a greedy engage from Kyle to go in on Demon Kite, and then Marco was not around, I assume. How the fuck Demon Kite not die? The team backed off with the Beatrix Bennett's Rage and Imbue's Passion.
He wasn't able to get taken down, and that is a W for RGPH. Meanwhile, another objective battle we're seeing.
I think Phew did not use the love waves onto, or the hard guard onto Kyle TZ, that's why he died. And also, Eman went for Assassin Emblem. That's why he deals so much damage. What
next? Okay, Nats gets solo kill. Kyle getting the retry again. The hook goes off on Flap though, and Flap dies. Marco gets the ult on Demon Kite. Good kill for him. AP Bren seems to get the lead back with that. But they're kind of like even-ish.
Blade of Despair now available for Eman, and the fact that AP Bren took out Demon Kite means that they can actually access the purple buff.
Oh, Light tries the flicker ult. Doesn't really work well here. Owen is fine, but Aqua with the flicker Akai ult. But Marco's still gonna live. Wow, and then Kyle teasing with the re-engage. Double pin on Emon and Aqua. Aqua's gonna barely live. Kyle 1 HP gets out. Overall, really clean fight from AP Bren. Insane fight from AP Bren.
For AP Bren, 1k gold lead. That was huge. Whoa. And that was huge because they tried to go for Super Marco, but the hard card is already off cooldown.
Yep.
And you also have the Blast of the Oasis already. He has it already up top. That's why they managed to keep Super Marco alive for those three kills. In fact, right now, Super Marco is leading by 200 gold just because of that. And they get additional kills. Overall, AP Bren.
Or do what you say, go on Fed. I mean, yeah, that's their win condition. Oh, Light with the hook on Marco. Marco with the purify second skill. Light didn't have ult anyway, just came up.
But Wolf, what I've seen right now, just now, was actually that securing Fury Hammer after a Blade Armor first item, I believe. So proper respect towards the one from Super Marco.
Interesting. He's farming so well. He is split pushing the map for now.
The pack split push is going crazy here.
Or economy for RSG Philippines. There will should be a trade here, especially because Kyle TZ is waiting on the wing.
Emon not showing himself smart. Oh, Demon Kite with the engage on Ogwen, but no follow up really. Ogwen's still alive here. Aqua using a Kyle to get out. Light with the ult onto Supermarco, no follow up. And Light just dies for nothing.
We'll be punished.
Well, very weird fight for RSG Philippines. They still fought. I tried to burst down one member. Knowing full well that CalTZ is not showing in the map, they should have respected that counterplay coming out from maybe Brennan. Indeed, it was a wonderful counterplay. It's RSG Philippines now trailing behind when it comes to the gold.
They are trailing, but...
Greedy engage from Demon Kite. Not all people can follow up like that.
As I said earlier, if there is a point lock hero that can suppress you down, like a Franco or Kaja, it's going to be hard for Super Marco to be able to play it safely. Especially AP Bren, the only real damage dealer that they have is that 1-1. So once that 1-1 is gone, it's going to be an easy team fight for RSG.
Yeah, if RSG can somehow kill Super Marco, they can win. In the future. Oh, Demon Kite getting pinned here. And he's dead. Marco gets the ult off onto Aqua. Aqua forces the flicker. Huge. I wonder why Super Marco bought Sea Halberd though. Demon Kite's not really healing an insane amount.
Demon Kite being caught in the same spot twice this game already. The first time. It was able, they were able to kind of turn it around. Because
seems like Bren actually wants to try to win, unlike yesterday.
Did not have any exchange.
Where they just
and it's weird because it is Demon Kite holding
went the most insane
push.
Comp.
Typically you want to look at Light, but if you think more about it, maybe it's because RSG Philippines wants to put Light in a more of a setup kind of play where the vision should come from someone else. But that's how you generally play the Franco. Your Franco will not be the main hero to kind of get into the bush and control that bush. You need someone else to be there. And CalTZ reading that perfectly well. Twice already in this game, they found it, feigned another kill onto Demon Kite.
TLB got 8th, not 6th.
I think that's the actual, the right solution too for RCPH because Alcuin always on Super Marco. Try to cover if there is a cash.
That's... Seems like he tried to engage, but chose not to. Light looking for a pick here. Hooks on Ogwen. Ult goes off. Ogwen gets bursted down. But Super Marco looking for an engage here. Onto Light, gets the ult off. Aqua, not a good spot here. Heavy spin goes off, but Sakamaru is dead anyway. Emon gets pinned by the heavy spin. Oh, final slash goes off on Demon Kite. And that's a 4-for-1 for AP Bren.
I thought Super Marco would get the hard guard, but apparently it doesn't really matter. That was the right play from Few to be able to just prolong the HP bar from Ogwen. And
seems like it might just be a quick 2-0 for AP Bren if they keep it up at this rate.
Super Marco 7-0-2. Another important item secured, Wolf, in that Malphic Roar.
Gonna be a big problem now for RSG Philippines. In that particular fight as well, there is the orange Soul of Lava available for Super Marco. That's why he actually hit like a truck against the members of RSG Philippines. And AP Bren, they have recovered even after Ogwen died, knowing full well that there's no control anymore for the 1-1. There's no suppression that will be applied to the 1-1. So technically speaking, there's nobody that can contest Super Marco during that moment. And Super Marco read that perfectly. Looked for the targets into the backlines and then utilized the crossbow tank to destroy RSG Philippines.
High grounds, only the towers are left, minus that bot tower. Oh, Demon Kite with two man knockup. Ogwen gets pulled. Ogwen falls. Kyle falls as well. Nats looking for a flank opportunity here. Conceal goes off. Light still has ult. Nats. Double knockup on a flap. Doesn't seem like he's doing anything. Marco with the re-engage. But Light with the ult on a Marco. Two man knockup. Flaps all alone. 1v5. Can Flap do anything? No. Flap. Actually, Flap's going crazy here. An attempt flickers out. Isn't going to matter though. Seems like he just gets out barely. 4-0, RSGPH, huge. Honestly, really huge.
Did Light didn't pop the Bloody Hunt in that siege situation just now, or the Bloody Hunt cooldown is already over?
Well, we'll see through the replay. I think it's the best way to look at it. But yeah, it was eventually just available at that specific moment. Yeah, Light does have the ultimate. Look at the stun. It actually connected onto Demon Cat instead of the instead of Light, which is kind of weird from Flap. And I think the call here for AP Bren is that they have the crossbow tank anyway, so they can fight. But Flap TZ, he stunned Demon Kite instead of
Light. There's a replay.
In that moment, I kind of, if you think about it, yeah, sure, it makes a lot of sense because Demon Kite will be a problem eventually. But what generally happened is that they didn't have a stun to kind of.
Remember the try 3v5? Yeah. They didn't know Light still had his ult. It was a huge clutch from Light to still keep his ult for Marco. That's why they won that fight, or like the last three at least. They would have lost if Light didn't have ult.
Composition is kind of gonna fall off in the late game because they only have that one TP as into Marco, and you can counter that even with just an item, Winter Truncheon or even Wind of Nature. Whoever can build it has to build it.
All of a sudden, this game is winnable for PH, RSGPH.
I think I believe Sanford in the previous games, and I
feel like they just kill Marco. GG. What the hell, Kyle? No conversion just yet. He whiffed the spin. He could have just stood there and be fine, but he whiffed. Why?
Gold gap. I believe our GPH has opportunities to again turn the game around or equalize that piece.
Very much winnable for RSG Philippines from before, where it kind of feels like AP Bren already got advantage. But RSG Philippines instead will be able to turn it around. 2,000 gold lead.
Yep. Okay. Oh, hook goes off on a flap.
Okay.
Flap though, trying to engage, backs off.
That one, but Hunt does not,
it was smart for Light to not ult that, because we would have just gotten instantly dove. They could have maybe bursted Light, or not Light, Flap, but like it wouldn't matter, because the team would just get dove on by Kyle, Marco, and Ogwen.
And I think that's the best decision, right, Wolf? Because a lot of times, a lot of Franco users, once they have the hook, it's always the Hunt.
But right now, it's actually an even game, even though 2k gold lead.
Akai, the response gonna be faster.
Oh, they're bursting the Lord this time.
Venom's Rage already going off quite early here. Demon Kite now in a good spot here. Gets pinned by Kyle. Lord gets bursted down, free Lord for Kyle. But Kyle dies. Light with the flicker ult on a Margo, it's not gonna hit do anything. Margo with the Wind of Nature. Looking for a re-engage here. Light 1 HP, Flap going in. But they're just gonna go for Nats to pick off Nats there. Flap looking for a re-engage here. He does have the flicker ult, but he's not gonna do anything. 1-for-1 trade, and Bren gets the Lord. So overall, pretty fine.
But up top, it was a slow push from AP Bren, and then
kind of messy fight though. Really messy fight from RSG.
Of the Lord, pull it towards their side, and then try to burst it. And RSG Philippines, after the moment that they saw that the Lord is being taken out. They fought.
Hook on the flap. Into a knockup from Demon Kite. Two man knockup on Ogwin and Flap. Marco looking for a re-engage though. Marco with the ult goes off. Winter Trench goes off though from Demon Kite dies. But Brand quite low, choosing to maybe back off here. Flicker roll to Ogwin, but he dies! The Beatrix Sniper! What is he doing? Ogwin tried flicker roll thing, he just got popped by Beatrix. Wait, is RSGPH actually gonna come back from this?
At least they live to see another day because of that hook.
It's not that Wanwan does no damage, it's that Winter Trunch counters Wanwan so hard. As soon as she gets ult on someone, they just Winter Trunch.
Outputting the damage, very much on point, not wasting any of the spells that he has. A Benetrage, as well as the Nibiru's Passions, not wasting it, and even the Renner's Apathy. And then, you have Demon Kite. He might have died, for sure. But the Winter Trunch in play allowed them to bait out AP Brynn, committing more. I mean, they have lost their turret in the middle.
Two winners, yeah, they got two winners. Franco with MO, and Beatrix will win.
Another push against AP Brynn.
I mean, and Pack has MO too. So like they all are getting Wanwan counter items now.
Would have been over for RGPH, but right now AP Brand, they still have a little bit of gold on their favor after the siege. But the game ain't
over. Whoa, light, not a good spot here. Aqua flickers out. Emon flickers, not Aqua. Emon flickers out, but Emon, bad spot, dies. Light getting pinned by Kyle. Gonna lose his MO and he's going to die. Really bad for Bren. They might, really bad for RSGPH. They might lose here. Huge for Bren. Emon with the massive damage dealt. Next to Super Marco. Might be a GG. Nats with a huge flank on the wave. He's gonna clear the whole mid wave. But Bren's gonna go for the bot wave. They might be able to end with his Sill. Ult goes off from Aqua. Demon Kite. Aqua trying the best there to defend. But Flap stuns Aqua, pulls him out of the tower. Nats trying his best to defend the tower as well. Demon Kite as well. Trying to hit the minion. It's just that one minion. Can he defend it? Nice Winter Trunch. It stalls. Emon is here. He clears the wave. He backs off. Really smart to not ult it because he needs ult for the next wave. Kyle has ult. He might try to ult this wave here. Light looking for a flank. The ult goes off. Oh, and Light hooks the cannon minion out. But Emon gets pinned under tower. It's not going to matter. It was a really good attempt from Light though. And it's a GG. For game one to AP Brand.
AP Brand, they're done playing around, man.